Isaiah, the first chapter. And the 18th verse, it says, come now and let us reason together, saith the Lord Yahweh. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool. Right? And the Lord cleanse us from basically being under the lie that was pushed by this America, basically, this world, Esau, Edom, right? The so-called white man, the wicked the Bible speaks of. Right, so it says in verse 5, and upon her forehead was a name written, Mystery Babylon, the great mother of harlots and abominations of the earth. All right, so basically that Babylon is talking about America, all right, because it's a mystery. Right, the former Babylon is well known, it's out there, but this Babylon basically is a mystery. And the reason why we know this is the Babylon that's being spoken of in the book of Revelations is down to the fact there's multiple scriptures that back up that point. All right, before I go there, let me read this precept quickly. So it's the book of Nahum 3:1. It says, woe to the bloody city, it is full of lies and robbery, the prey departeth not. All right, and the bloody city that's being spoken of is dealing with America. All right, it's saying that how is America being spoken of as a bloody city? Because what was America founded upon? All right, the blood of the so-called Native Americans, who the tribe of Gad in the Bible, all right? They basically got plundered by that bloody city being known as Babylon the Great, all right? But the Heavenly Father said, woe unto them, which the word woe means destruction, all right? So they basically
got signs coming.
The Lord got signs for them, basically, all right? So it says, the noise of the whip and the noise of the rattling of the wheels and the prancing horses and the jumping chariots. The horseman lifted up both the bright sword and the glittering spear, and there is a multitude of slain and a great number of carcasses, and there is none end to their corpses. They stumble upon their corpses. All right, that's the Heavenly Father is going to do that by way of the Third World War that's basically we're on the precipice of. Right now you're seeing that culminate right over there in the Middle East, right, with between America and Russia. Right, even right now you have a battlefront basically playing out in the Arctic, right, between the USA, right, Babylon the Great, and the Russians, basically, right. The Russians presently are basically training their snipers in Arctic weather to be able to basically snipe people out, right. So the warfare is drawing nigh. So that's but ultimately that's going to culminate to World War III, which World War III is going to be a firefight between, all right, NATO and the EU, not even NATO and the EU, is basically going to result in the destruction of America, all right? America turning into the lake of fire, which spoke of in the book of Revelations, all right? So it says, reading on, it says, verse 5, behold, I am against thee, saith the Lord of hosts, and I will discover thy skirts upon thy face, and I will show the nations thy nakedness and the kingdoms thy shame. Right, that's why even right now, hey, America's looking very shameful in the world stage, right? When you're dealing with the rulers that are at work right now, all right? The once great splendor that America had is now in the dirt, basically. You had a ruler such as Donald Trump that ruled for 4 years. And guess what? You're going to find out that Donald J. Trump is better than Biden, all right? That's what people are going to find out. Because they're so fed up with Trump, all right, that they basically just were ready to take anyone in office, all right? But Biden's got he's got a lot of blood on his hands, even at Kamala Harris, well, she's a piece of work as well, man. Right, that duo that's basically in the White House right now, they ain't gonna do no one no favors. They're gonna bring about a draconian rulership, all right? And all willing, they're gonna bring about the end of this society, all right? By all the policies they set in place, all right, and all the little actions that they step towards doing, they're basically gonna do the bidding of the Heavenly Father, all right, in terms of bringing about this destruction. That's why it says this, behold, I'm against thee, all right? The Heavenly Father said he's against thee, all right? It says saith the Lord of hosts, I will discover thy skirts upon thy face, and I will show the nations thy nakedness, and the kingdoms thy shame. All right, and that's what's being seen right now. So it says, and I will cast abominable filth upon thee, and make thee vile, and will set thee as a gazing stock. All right, and that's what's going to happen. It's happening, and it's going to come to its peak,
and
it's time that we're in. All right, so. Okay, so back in Isaiah 13 and 1. So it says, the burden of Babylon, which Isaiah the son of Amos did see. Lift ye up a banner upon a high mountain, exalt the voice unto them, shake thy hand, that they may go into the gates of the nobles. Alright? Hey, and even after what brother went into it, he basically said, like, hey, what we're doing right now is basically more or less like a approving process of basically where this is gonna hit its peak is basically when we're out. Whoever's lawyer is to be presented before the elites in the society, basically, to tell them to their face their judgment, right? That's why we're basically on the highways and byways prophesying. But it says, I'll read it again, it says, Isaiah 13 and 2 says, lift ye up a banner upon a high mountain. Right, the banner we're lifting up is basically this Bible, the words of this book. We're lifting up, and how are we doing it? By prophesying the word of this Bible. We're letting the people know, right? Because the book, in this same book, it tells you Isaiah 34:1, it tells you to be we're prophets unto the nations as well. Because we got to basically be heralds unto Yahweh, Baal Shem, El Shai, to let them know what judgment they got coming, right? So that's why we're lifting up the banner. Exalt the voice unto them, shake the hand, that they may go into the gates of the nobles, all right? So ultimately, that's where it's going to lead to, all right? The gates of the nobles. Hey, back then, when you had the Lord, he basically made the same, he gave forth a commission unto his disciples at the time, right, before they became apostles, and basically said to them, like, look, all right, I'm going to, you know, Matthew chapter 10 basically breaks it down, and where he basically told them all the things that had happened to them. Right, but then one of the key people that Yahweh Shai really got on heavy was Peter. Right, Peter got it the most. He got air for every moment. Right, it wasn't a moment that the Heavenly Father didn't give him. I mean, Yahweh Shai didn't give him air bashing basically. And the reason why is because he was preparing him for the time that he was going to go into. Because he went before the hierarchy of the nation of Israel, being the Sanhedrin. The high priest at the time, and he went before the various different high people in different high offices, and basically made the words of the Heavenly Father known unto the masses. Fuck. Alright? That's the reason why he went through all that. So that was a fulfillment of what's being spoken in Isaiah 13. So it says, verse 3, it says, I have commanded my sanctified ones, I have also called my mighty ones for mine anger, even them that rejoice in my highness. All right, so basically the Lord in the book of John basically spoke about sanctify them with this truth, basically, right? And the way you'd be sanctified, right, the word sanctify basically means to be made clean, right? And the way Psalms 119 and 9 basically tells you how therein shall a young man cleanse his way, by the washing of the word. All right, the book of Ephesians 5 and 26 also tells you about the washing by way of the word. All right, so basically by taking heed to these words and basically following the Heavenly Father's way, rehearsing the righteous acts as we're told to do and as we're prophesied to do, basically makes us as to where we fulfill this. All right, so I'll read it again. So it says, I've commanded my sanctified ones, I've also called my mighty ones for mine anger, even them that rejoice in my highness, all right? And, hey, like we're coming out, the Lord said, he sent for many fishers, a and they shall fish them. And afterward, I send for many hunters, and they shall hunt them. All right? But then also you have the ICBMs. You have the different spirits that are going to be sent forth for, as it tells you in the book of Sirach 39, about there be spirits that be made for vengeance. All right? So verse 4, it says, the noise of a multitude in the mountains like a great people, a tumultuous noise of the kingdoms of nations gathered together. The Lord of hosts mustered the host of the battle. And this is speaking about ICBMs, all right? That's what he's mustering together, all right? In the book of, in the same book, in the 44th chapter, it tells you about the Lord creating a smith that bloweth the coals to bring forth the instrument. And the instrument that's being spoken is the ICBMs, all right? Those things inside those silos all over the world, all right, with said different powers, they ain't there for show, all right? They're there to be used one day. They weren't made in vain, all right? They, you know, what a lot of people fail to realize, and it's really been through the witchcraft of wording, all right, is that basically when it says, they call it a nuclear deterrent, all right, by the fact that everyone's got ICBMs, like this country has an ICBM, that country has an ICBM. Basically, it's a stalemate. And no one's going to fire their ICBMs because no one wants it as to where that, you know, there's an all-out nuclear warfare. But what they don't understand is that, hey, there's certain countries, they're willing to take a loss, all right, on their part. And more so in tune with the scriptures, all right, and the spirit of Yahweh Hashem El Shai, America's prophesied to be destroyed, all right? So that's that. It's going to be destroyed, all right? And that prophecy has to be fulfilled.